Good afternoon students, welcome all of you to 10th standard English class. In this video we are going to see the second unit prose, The Night the Ghost Got In, written by James Grover Thurber. We are going to see the last part of the lesson in this video. Before that we'll recall the previous part of the lesson. So in the previous part we have seen that the narrator went to the attic and everything was confused. Their noisy footsteps and operations made the grandfather think that they were General Meade's men beginning to withdraw. However, when they got to the attic, grandfather thought that the police were deserters from Meade's army. So he tried to hide himself away in his attic, that is in his room. The grandfather at once took his zither gun from his holster and fired at them, in which one policeman was shot in his arm. In this, now we are going to see the next part of the lesson. Next paragraph. The cops were reluctant to leave without getting their hand on somebody besides grandfather. The night had been distinctly a defeat for them. Furthermore, they didn't like the layout. Something looked, and I can see their viewpoint, phony. They began to poke into things again. A reporter, a thin-faced, wispy man, came up to me. I had put on one of mother's dress and not being able to find anything else. The reporter looked at me with mingled suspicion and interest. "Just what the hell is the real lay down here, bud?" he asked. Now we'll see the meaning for the hard words. Reluctant. Reluctant means not willing. And the next one is obviously. Obviously means certainly. Next one, phony, that is not genuine. Next one is wispy, a small thin man. Now we'll see the explanation part. The cops were reluctant to leave, that is the policemen were not willing to leave without getting their hands on somebody besides their grandfather, and this narrator had to put one of his mother's dress, that is the author was wearing his mother's dress. He was not able to find anything else. So the reporter looked at him with suspicion. Next part, I decided to be frank with him. "We had ghost," I said. He gazed at me a long time as if I were a slot machine into which he had, without results, dropped a coin. Then he walked away. The cops followed him. The one grandfather shot, holding his now bandaged arm, cursing and blaspheming, and got my gun back from the old bird," said the zither cop. "Yeah," said Joe. "You and who else?" "I told them I would bring it to the station house the next day." We'll see the explanation part for this paragraph. So at last, the narrator doesn't know what to do. So the narrator decided to be frank with the policeman, and he told that they had ghost in their house that night. Then the reporter gazed at the narrator for a long time, as if the narrator was a slot machine into which he had dropped a coin without any results. Then, without uttering any words, the reporter just walked away. The cops followed him. The one grandfather shot, holding his now bandaged arm, cursing and blaspheming, and told that I'm gonna get my gun back from that old bird," said the zither cop. So here the policeman got angry, and the narrator told them that he would bring it to the station, the house, the next day. Next para. What was the matter with that one policeman? Mother asked. after they had gone. Grandfather shot him, I said. What for? She demanded. I told her he was a deserter. Of all things, said mother. He was such a nice looking young man. So the perplexed and confused police left the house. Then mother asked the narrator what's the matter with that one particular policeman, and the narrator told that the grandfather shot him. According to the narrator's mother, the policeman who was shot by the grandfather was a nice looking young man. Now we are going to see the last paragraph in this lesson. Grandfather was fresh as a daisy and full of jokes at breakfast next morning. We thought at first he had forgotten all what happened, but he hadn't. Over his third cup of coffee, he glared at Herman and me. What was the idea of all these cops, Terry Hooten, round the house last night? He demanded. None of you bothered to leave a bottle of water beside my bed. Do you ever realize what it cost for a thirsty man to look for water in the dining room last night? He had us there. Now we'll see the explanation part now. The next morning, grandfather was fresh and was full of jokes at breakfast. He joins the army family in the dining table as cool as cucumber. They thought at first he had forgotten all about what had happened, but he had not. Over his third cup of coffee, he started at the narrator and asked Herman why the cops were wandering round the house the previous night. Here a slang expression is used. What was the idea of all them cops Terry Hooten round the house last night? Idea means idea. Then Terry Hooten means working up round the house last night. Then the grandfather complained that none of them remembered to keep a bottle of water beside his bed. He complained that he felt very thirsty. The whole situation is highly comical, leaving all of us to wonder at this situation. The story is thrilling and amusing and makes us spellbound. Hope you have understood the lesson, children. Now kindly go through the lesson in the PDF. Next, we are going to see the vocabulary exercises given in this lesson, page number 35. The topic is singular and plural forms. Singular means only one, plural more than one. So in this lesson we find plural forms such as furniture, houses, windows, burglars, boxes, shelves, policemen. You may notice that the words have taken up different suffixes to form plurals. This is because English words have different origin. Plurals can be formed by adding different suffixes like s, es, ies, etc. For example, book, books, by adding s, pen, pens. Now we'll see the words given in the tabular column. Let's learn how we are going to change the words into plural forms. First, we'll see the words ending with y. For example, city, c-i-t-y. So that y is replaced as i-e-s. Likewise, family, f-a-m-i-l-y. Family, families, f-a-m-i-l-i-e-s. Then words ending in f. For example, leaf. So we are adding what? V-E-S. That F is removed and written as, changed as V-E-S. Loaf. L-O-A-F. The plural form is loaves. L-O-A-V-E-S. Next one. Words ending in um will take a. For example, medium, medium. This um is replaced as media. So the plural form for medium is media. Likewise, stratum, strata. Memorandum, memoranda. Next one is erratum, errata. Aquarium, aquaria. Next one, words ending with us, the plural form is formed by adding I. For example, alumnus, us. That is, we are using I and making it as plural form, alumni. Next one, focus, foci. Locus, loci. Next, we'll go to the next one. Some words take plurals of a different form. Let's see a few examples in that. First one is ox. The plural form for ox is oxen. Likewise, another word, child. The plural form for child is children. Now, we'll see the exercise given in the book. That is exercise D. Complete the given tabular columns with the suitable plural forms. First one, chair, chairs. Just we are adding S and make it as plural form. Next one is box, boxes. Eskimo, Eskimos. Lady, ladies. Radius, radii, R-A-D-I-I. Next one is formula, formulae. Child, children. Deer, deer. In this, no change. We are using it as it is. Next one is loaf, loaves, L-O-A-V-E-S. And the last one is hero, heroes. Next, we are going to see the grammar part, articles. Let's see the what are articles. A, an, and the are called articles. In this, we have definite article and indefinite article. Let's see which is the definite article. That is, the is the definite article and a, an are indefinite articles. Definite article tells about a specific definite person, place or thing. For example, the computer laboratory. Next one is indefinite articles. They tell us about any person, place or thing. For example, the library. That is, it is specified. A library. It is non-specific. An orange. Non-specific. Next, we'll see about the indefinite articles. That is, a or an. A or an is determined by sound. A word beginning with a vowel sound, an is used. Example, an ass, an orange, an umbrella, an or. When a word begins with a consonant sound, a is used. For example, a boy, a woman, a house, a hole. We use a or an with singular nouns only. Example, a girl, an orange. Next one, we use a with singular nouns and adjectives which begin with a consonant sound. For example, a computer, a wonderful artist, a unit. That is unit, U plus nit. Next, we use an with singular nouns and adjectives which begin with a vowel sound. For example, an artist. And the next word is MLA. But we are using an. M is not a vowel letter, but the pronunciation is MLA. And the next one, an honest shopkeeper. Here in this example, H is not a vowel letter, but we are using the article an. Words beginning with H and not accented on the first syllable, and so the article an is often used. Next, we should note the following things. First one, words beginning with consonant letters do not always begin with consonant sound. Similarly, words beginning with vowel letters do not always begin with vowel sounds. See the examples given here. Honor sounds like honor. European sounds like European. Next, we are going to see the use of definite article the. We use the when a person, an animal, a plant, a place, a thing is mentioned for a second time. The example is given below here. I bought a book this morning. I am reading the book now. In the first part of the sentence, we are using the article a book, whereas in the second part, the book. So it refers here the noun is mentioned for the second time. First point, we use the when it is clear to the listener or reader which person, animal, place or thing we are referring to. For example, the judge found him not guilty. Next one, we use the when there is only one such thing, that is unique or special things. For example, the earth goes round the sun. Here we are using article the earth. Likewise, before sun we are using the article the. The third point, we usually use the before ordinal numbers. Example, I live on the third floor. Sheila got the first rank. Fourth point, we use the before some proper nouns such as the Indian Ocean, the Arabian Sea, the Bay of Bengal. Next, fifth point, we use the before names of most buildings, landmarks, monuments and natural wonders. Few examples for this. The Park Hotel, the Taj Mahal. Sixth point, we use the before names of places containing of. Example, the Republic of China. Next point, that is seventh one, the names of places ending in plurals. Example, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Next example is the Netherlands. Here islands, it is ending in plural form. Netherlands, it is also ending in plural forms. Eighth point, some proper nouns are not preceded by an article. For example, the names of continents, countries, towns and cities, and even the names of streets. Example, Ritchie Street. Ninth point, some nouns can be counted and they are called as countable nouns. For example, book, pen, chair, etc. will come under countable nouns. Some cannot be counted and they are called uncountable nouns. For example, rice, sugar, etc. We use a or an only before countable nouns. Example, a leaf fell off the tree. Here, a leaf. So, it is a countable noun. Next example is, rain can cause flooding. It is an uncountable noun. Tenth point, we use the with uncountable nouns when it is clear to the reader which things we are referring to. We do not use the with uncountable nouns when we are talking in general. Uncountable nouns do not take up the plural forms. Let's see the example. The rice in this supermarket is good. Rice is the staple food of Asians. The last point, the word some can be used with both countable and uncountable nouns in the following ways. Example, I want some apples. Next example is, I want some paper. We'll see the remaining part in the next video lesson. Hope you have understood the grammar and vocabulary part. Kindly go through the exercises given in page number 35, 40 and 41. Thank you, students. May God bless you.